Hi everyone, I'm Daniel Chait, co-founder and CEO at Greenhouse, recruiting optimization software that helps companies plan, execute, and optimize a better recruiting process end to end. I graduated in the mid-90s with a degree in software engineering from the University of Michigan. I've been an entrepreneur for nearly 20 years. I've played every role from recruiter to head of HR to sales and engineering. And Greenhouse is definitely the most exciting company that I've ever been a part of. I'd like to tell you a little bit about why. So we're in a crowded space. By my count, there's about 250 or more recruiting platforms of some form or another, and yet we've managed to clearly separate ourselves from the rest. Let me tell you a little bit about kind of what that looks like and sort of why I think that is. Excuse me. So first, we've grown from zero to about 1,000 customers in just under 2 years. The New York Times recently named us as one of the 50 companies that's likely to become one of the new startup unicorns. Based on our growth, and we've raised about $60 million in venture capital from top VCs, including Social Capital Partnership, Benchmark, and Thrive Capital. Now, so that's a little bit of what it feels like. Why is it that we've been able to do this? I think, first and foremost, we focused on elevating the class of problem that we're solving. You know, before us, everyone in our industry basically said, look, recruiting's a hassle. It's a big administrative problem with lots of paperwork. We're going to make it super easy so you can dispatch with it and get back to the real business at hand. And Greenhouse came out with a different idea. We said recruiting is the real business at hand. If you want to build a great company, you have to be good at recruiting. You have to be smarter about it. You have to be more competitive at it. And you need a lot of tools and automation in order to get there. So Greenhouse set out to build a set of tools to give people the power to help build better companies. So I'd like to do in the time I have left is give you a quick walkthrough of what those tools are and just show you some of the highlights of the things we've done that are different than anything anyone else has done before us. So first is this. In most companies, the people involved in hiring generally don't know with any level of clarity who they're trying to hire. What are the criteria that matter? How are we going to evaluate each candidate and know who's the best person for us? Greenhouse allows you to configure a unique scorecard for each job so everybody's on the same page with exactly the decision that you need to make, who to move forward with, which candidate's gonna be the best for this particular role. In most companies, nobody knows what the process is. Nobody knows how the recruiting engine is supposed to work. So there's lots of running around, lots of huddles, lots of scrambling, and you really can't tell the candidate what they can expect next or how long the process is gonna take. Greenhouse, you can configure a customizable interview plan for each job so everybody knows exactly what's gonna happen next. Everybody knows what their role is, what role they're supposed to play in the interview process, and how they're supposed to participate. You can give great clarity and you can measure performance much more accurately. In most companies, an interview is basically taking somebody off their desk, throwing them in a room with a candidate, and hoping they figure it out. Of course, interviewers generally spend that hour hoping to get out of the meeting alive. They make up their own brain teasers, they chit-chat about hobbies, it's a disaster. In Greenhouse, every interview is driven by an interview kit, which gives clear guidance to the interviewer about what questions they should ask and what they should focus on. Interview feedback in most companies is a mess. It's completely haphazard, and people generally send some emails or they give a thumbs up in the hallway. It's often not recorded, and the feedback tends to be very inactionable. In Greenhouse, driven by the scorecard, all the interviews are provided with a configurable interview scorecard back to the team, so that you collect exactly the actionable information you need to make smart decisions and do it faster. How many people in the room think it's a good idea to ask candidates what they think about your company, what they think about your interview process? And of those, how many people religiously do this? Right, okay, so very, very few. Greenhouse is a checkbox, and you can send a great interview experience survey to all your candidates, and you know exactly what you're doing, how well you're working, and what you can be doing better in the process. How many people think it's a good idea to stay in touch with candidates and let them know what's happening next in the process or when you're not going to move forward with them? And most companies, how often is that actually done? So Greenhouse makes it super easy to use templates, get back to candidates, and give them the feedback that they need. In most companies, sourcing is a mess. Greenhouse organizes it all into a holistic dashboard so you know exactly where to spend your time and energy, whether it's referral program, job ads, and the like. We integrate tons of recruiting technology more than anyone on our APIs, including Intello and Plum, who presented earlier, and it all fits in the palm of your hand. Any questions?
Thank you, Daniel. The perfect example of a company that has automated a complicated process and a process that many people in an organization is not their primary, necessarily, their primary job, but yet they're asked to do it every day, or not every day, but on a regular basis. Justin, why don't we start with you?
So I'm sad to say you actually fairly accurately described the interview process at GE and many of the problems that we struggle with. But I find myself sitting here wondering, like, why has nobody before you tried to solve this problem? I mean, we've been in 20 plus years in the internet era. Why did you suddenly stumble upon this and no one else has?
Yeah, so I would say there's two reasons for that. First is, like, if you look at certain companies who really have made their own investment in this, what you see is they have done this. So at Google, they've built tons of tools. They have data scientists, they have automation engineers, they have lots of programmers, and they build these type of tools themselves. So there's like a small group of companies who have made this investment themselves and built tools like ours, and really we're commercializing ideas that have been well-known and popular for decades. Or structured interviewing isn't something I came up with in a PhD. It's been known for a long time. So I think the second part is, you know, traditionally, as I said at the beginning, you know, the category is called applicant tracking systems, which I think tells you the story right there. Recruiting used to be you place a want ad in the New York Times, and you get applicants, and you sift through the resumes, there's a lot of paperwork, and you choose the one you want to hire. It's not like that anymore. So there's been a real change in kind of the power dynamic between companies and people, and this type of thing is now being much more needed, I think, than it used to be.
Alex?
So very compelling vision of what a good HR kind of hiring process, you know, looks like. I'm curious, kind of from your perspective, given the other tools out there, not necessarily in the applicant tracking systems, but the overall tools for the HR department, what is the ideal set of tools that your customers use? So in addition to your product,
sure,
what else do they have?
So we participate basically from, you can think of it as like prospecting through the moment that you hire. At that point, you go up into like HR world and you're an employee. But from a recruiting standpoint, that entire workflow is increasingly driven by technology. And there's, as you must know in what you do, tons of new companies, tons of new technology, lots of really smart thinking and data science, as you've seen from the earlier presenters. It's never been integrated before. So if you look at like the prospecting alone, you know, it's not just Intello, but if you're hiring salespeople, there's different tools. If you're hiring creative professionals, there's different tools. If you're assessing people, there's tons of assessment tools. There's tons of tools for like things like background checks, mm-hmm, and interview scheduling. And there's all this, there's a whole niche ecosystem there. And so we really launched with the first kind of API platform so that all these guys can work together. Because if you're just an assessment tool or just a sourcing tool, if it doesn't work together, it's not easily used. So there's been a real need to kind of bring that ecosystem into one kind of experience.
Ian?
Yeah, so that was the thing that was jumped out most at me was the platform approach to this, right? I think there's a, to Justin's point, there's a real opportunity for someone to put the platform together to manage this ecosystem of activities much more effectively. It sounds like you're on the right track and you're doing the right stuff. Could you talk a little bit about the partnerships that you have and how you're cultivating those?
Yeah, so I mean, it starts with our APIs. And so, you know, early on, we realized that, we were hearing from, and still probably true today, like between 1 to 2 a week of some recruiting technology or other that needs to integrate with their applicant tracking system. And now their customers are telling them, we use Greenhouse, you know, we need you to be on the platform. So over time, initially we would do the integrations kind of one by one with that partner as the customers would request. And then we started to tease out what the categories are. And they kind of break down as I described. There's like sourcing and prospecting stuff. There's assessment, test taking things of various types, whether it's giving a coding test or giving a personality screen or giving someone some writing samples to do, et cetera. And then there's kind of like mid workflow things around calendar scheduling or, you know, paperwork, you know, handling. And then finally like onboarding and HR. And so we built kind of APIs for each of those pieces. And then we let the companies basically do those integrations. So that way, as our mutual customers want to use the product, it's really easy. And what we hear from those companies as they go to market is like, generally speaking, to integrate with an ATS is difficult or impossible. And with us, it's like, yep, here's the developer portal, here's the API documentation, go to town, have a test environment. It's like a half a day work, it's very easy.
And are you leveraging those relationships from a channel sales perspective?
It works both ways.
Yeah.
Right? So on the one hand, our customers will often ask us for a solution that includes not just Greenhouse, but they also want to source developers and they also want to do digital interviewing.
Yeah.
So we'll introduce them to HireVue and we'll introduce them to Intello. And likewise, if you talk to Intello sales reps, you say, what's the most common complaint that your prospects are telling you? It's they say, I hate my applicant tracking system. Can you recommend something better? Mm-hmm. Right. So we get tons of inbound requests from our partners that way as well. So it works both ways.
Okay, thank you. So I encourage everyone who is hiring to try Greenhouse and the other Plum and Intello. They're all addressing different parts of the hiring process. A big round of applause for Daniel and for our judges. Thank you very much. Thank you.